Meanwhile, the U.S. administration has announced significant budget cuts for the United Nations for 2018-19. The funding cut move comes after UN denounced Donald Trump's decision to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital. Earlier, U.S. had warned UN of damaging consequences if it went ahead to denounce Trump's Jerusalem decision. U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, announced that UN's upcoming year's budget will be slashed by $285 million. Haley said, and I quote, "The inefficiency and overspending of the United Nations are well known. We will no longer let the generosity of the American people be taken advantage of or remain unchecked," unquote. The U.S. pays about 22% of the UN's budget, or roughly $3.3 billion. Joining me live on the broadcast is WION's senior foreign editor, Padma Rao. Padma, clearly the U.S. appears to be in a very arm-twisting kind of a mode as far as the U.N. is concerned after its proposal to recognize Jerusalem was defeated in the U.N. General Assembly.
Yes, it is in an arm-twisting mode. In fact, this is the fourth time that the United States, either the envoy or the president, have brought up, you know, various threats if the UN doesn't do this and if the UN doesn't do that. Now, the thing is that the bullying that the United States will cut aid to countries, for instance, that voted against Mr. Trump's Jerusalem move in the General Assembly, it won't really affect emerging economies, but it certainly will affect poorer countries if President Trump follows through on that. But what is accurate, Raghavendra, I think we need to, you know, see the wood for the trees, is that the United Nations is indeed a bloated and inefficient organization. It's got the world's highest paid bureaucracy and also the reform of the United Nations. And India is a strong supporter of the reform, especially of the Security Council. This has been pending for nearly 30 years, and there is absolutely no consensus. And the United Nations, it's also a fact, has indeed lost its post-World War II clout. And it's become, you know, a mere ceremonial world body. Now, as you can see, recently, the Big Five safeguarded, you know, they're safeguarded, the Big Five and the Security Council, from practically any disapproval by the world, by other countries, because of the great power we have. Now, you saw that recently, the United Nations General Assembly, 120 countries voted against President Trump's Jerusalem move. But in effect, that was just a symbolic vote. It has no There's no executive power that the GA really holds. And, for instance, the United Nations Security Council votes on things like sanctions on North Korea or sanctions on any other country, pretty much dependent on bilateral strategic disputes. Of course, there's no truth to what the United Nations said. And the cutting of the budget of the United Nations is even of the extension of keeping a humanitarian problem. And we will cut some